Students are a really integral part of the research in the North. They're spending time in a setting learning the trade, whether it's water sampling or soil sampling or working with data loggers or collecting other kinds of measurements. And at the same time, they're learning how to work in camps. They're learning logistics and breakdowns and problem solving. And they're learning to work with people in the North, and they're learning to be sensitive and tolerant of understanding different perspectives.
When you're up so far from civilization, you're all that you've got. And you've really got to figure out how to fix what issues arise when they arise.
When we're out there, we're the only people on that island. And that island is, you know, almost the size of New Brunswick. So it's an area that has been largely off of the research agenda for a lot of people because of inaccessibility. But we've been able to work there for a number of years. It's a vast land, and it's quite empty at this point, or it appears to be quite empty.
The reason I came to Queens was because I had the opportunity to do fieldwork in the High Arctic, a place where very few people get to go to.
I feel very fortunate to be a student at Queens because it's given me the opportunity to study what I study, to study it in the Arctic, and to contribute to a knowledge base that's growing bigger, stronger every year, and I feel like I'm a part of that change.
If you could put a bullseye on Canada where change is, environmental change is happening, it's really right over the central Arctic. This is the place where environment's changing, climate's changing, permafrost is changing, sea ice is changing, wildlife is changing, communities are changing, everything is changing.
The overall goal of my work is to produce maps that outline areas of high risk or susceptibility to landslides for areas across the Canadian High Arctic. So I'm hoping that my work can be not only used for community development in areas that where there already are existing communities that just want to expand, or for new communities that potentially may be in development in the future. And then not only for community, but there's also the infrastructure side for development of natural resources.
I'm grateful that there are people in the Queens community who contribute to my learning even after they've left. My time here has been so wonderful, and I want other people, other researchers, other students to have the kind of opportunities that I had.